Another 23-year-old Virginia Tech graduate is feeling people's rage. His website is drawing a lot of angry email, including death threats. Wayne Chang says he fits the shooter's profile, and his site, which used to get about 22,000 hits a day, is now getting more than 330,000 a day. Wayne Chang is in Washington. Wayne, tell us a little bit about your website and why it seems to be attracting attention.
I think the reason why is that the police gave a description of the shooter, and I think there's 5 points, and I matched all 5 of those points. They're looking for an Asian student at Virginia Tech who recently broke up with his girlfriend and stayed in West Amber Johnston. And I think the part that killed me the most was he liked to collect firearms.
And Wayne, we're looking right now at your website and at pictures of you posing with what looks to be a fair number of guns. Do you own these guns?
Yes, ma'am, I do.
Where did you get them?
I bought them through sources, through legal sources.
Through legal sources.
Yeah.
And how many do you have?
I have currently in my possession 21 firearms.
Where are they?
They're stored at my house.
In Virginia?
Yes, ma'am.
And why do you have so many guns, Wayne?
I like to collect guns, I like to competitively shoot, and I'm also getting into hunting as well.
And is there a reason that you have so many of them?
I believe it's sort of my way of expressing my patriotism, being a proud American.
What's the most efficient and most serious gun that you have, the most powerful?
I believe this is very evil looking, as the media likes to call it. It's a black, very small, sort of machine gun looking. I believe most people feel very scared when they see it. It's just this general misconception that this type of firearm would be used in such a tragedy. But the thing is that this type of firearm is very hard to get. It's federally controlled here in the United States. In order to possess such a firearm, you have to go through rigorous background checks. You have to submit 2 fingerprint cards, mug shots. You have to get the blessing of the chief local law enforcement officer, and then you have to pay a tax to the federal government in order to possess this.
Has anybody expressed concern to you, Wayne, about your interest in guns?
Yeah, people online says, oh, you seem to have an obsession with guns, you know, you collect a lot of guns. But I don't feel that way. I don't feel like I should have to apologize for exercising my Second Amendment rights.
What did you think when you heard about the massacre in Virginia?
Oh, I was absolutely appalled. I went to Virginia Tech, and I'm a Hokie, you know, they're my family.
Do you understand why people are so frightened of guns?
I do understand. I believe the media just has this bad misconception that firearms are just generally evil. There's no purpose in them, and I disagree with them.
And what is the purpose of firearms?
Recreational shooting, personal defense, there's plenty of reasons.
Do you think the police targeted you because of some sort of racial profiling, or do you think it's the fact that you have a cache of weapons that, wouldn't you agree, is fairly unusual?
I would not agree so. I think the reason why so many people suspected me was because I match the description of the shooter exactly.
Do you know other students, other young people in your age group that have as many weapons and as many powerful weapons as you do?
Yes, ma'am, I do.
Is this a sort of a hobby? I know that weapons are banned on the Virginia Tech campus, aren't they?
Yes, ma'am, they do. They are.
And is it something that you do as young people collect weapons?
You know, it depends. It's a culture of its own, you know. There's a culture for everything. People like cars, people like firearms, people like fishing. You'll always find a group, and you'll find plenty of people in it.
And you've received death threats, I understand.
Yes, ma'am. Just in the beginning, just so many people was like, oh, you know, you're the shooter, you know. How could you do this? Why did you do this? And people are just asking just questions to somebody who's supposedly dead. And they're just asking rhetorical questions to answers they'll never find.
All right, Wayne Chang in Washington, thanks for joining us on The Verdict.
Thank you for having me.
When we come back, how are people in Blacksburg, Virginia reacting to the disturbing images of killer Cho Sung Lee? In Washington, thanks for joining us on The Verdict.
Thank you for having me.
When we come back, how are people in Blacksburg, Virginia reacting to the disturbing images of killer Cho Sung Lee? I love it.
This is Jake Kahaney.
Yeah, yeah, there you go.
Okay. Okay.
That's perfect. Thanks for that.
Block three.
Yeah.
It took maybe a little bit of time out of this one.
Yeah.
The other one was good.
I just didn't want to let that guy go. Yeah. He was too freakish.
Oh, my God.
Your necklace.
Oh. And also your cable's hanging down the side.
Oh, gosh, I'm falling apart. I can't believe this.
Yeah, I know.
You think the media's doing the right thing? I mean, I know it's they
Jimmy can. Breslin.
Yes.
I'd like to say hi. It's Paula Todd. I'm a writer and a broadcaster in Canada, and I'm honored to have you on the line. Yeah.
What about the fellow you just had? Could you keep him?
Oh, my gosh. He's not on with us, but please feel free to talk about it.
What? Please what?
Feel free to talk about him.
No, I just want to hear him talk some more.
Yeah, he was incredible, huh?
Yeah, he's good. Where'd you get him from?
He's in Virginia.
Huh?
Yeah, write about him. I'd love to read that. And I'm looking for...